regime of South Vietnam's president Ngo Dinh Diem comes to an end in a wave of violence. A few days before the army revolt, these last pictures showed a man who seemed to have no premonition of the horrible death he was to meet as a wave of rebellion swept Saigon. Saigon he and his brother ruled as a personal province. The well-laid army plot began quietly during siesta time. Units of the 7th Army slipped into the city, seized key positions, and quickly ran headlong into stiff resistance from loyal Diem troops. Mortar fire concentrates on tanks and armored carriers blocking the way to the palace. When Diem refused to surrender after he was offered safe conduct, 16 rebel tanks rumbled up to Gia Long Palace. The revolt had its strange moments. Elated Vietnamese civilians formed cheering squads well within range of the heavy firing. For 2.5 hours, the palace comes under heavy bombardment before the white flag is raised. Meanwhile, Diem and his brother, Ngo Dinh Nhu, had fled the palace in disguise. They were later captured, only to die in an armored car that was taking them to prison. Within 18 hours, the revolt was over, and a military junta under General Duong Van Minh had taken over. They named Diem's vice president as premier of a caretaker regime, which has been recognized by the United States. News of the successful coup brought wild celebrations. In the early hours of the new government, there was widespread looting, most of it aimed at those who had been close to the deposed House of Diem. Pro-Diem newspaper plants were a favorite target, and soon it was hard to find a picture of President Diem or Madame Nhu that wasn't defaced or burned. A curfew was clamped on Saigon, and the new leaders called on the people to turn to the main business at hand, the war against the Viet Cong communists.